Hello, J-pop lovers. I'm Ko, a native Japanese vocal coach teaching singing in Vancouver, Canada. 皆さんこんにちは。ボイストレーナーの Ko です。Today, I'm going to talk about how to sing Lemon, written by Kenshi Yonezu. Even if you don't know how to read or speak Japanese, if you watch this video until the very end, not only you will be able to sing Lemon with natural Japanese pronunciation, but also you can learn secret techniques that Japanese singers use to make their singing sound good. All right, let's get started. First, let's take a look at some stylistic techniques that Kenshi uses in verse 1 to make his phrasing sound good in J-pop style. I'd say one of the most important thing when it comes to singing Japanese songs is to master where to stress syllables. All green highlighted words here are the stress syllables in this verse. You may have also noticed that most of the stress syllables are sung with a scooping up technique, which sounds like This scooping up technique is pretty common in J-pop to bring out the singer's feeling and make the listeners exciting. So the up sign you see at the top left means scooping up. So the first line of the song will sound like 夢ならばどれほどよかったでしょう。But if I didn't sing with stresses and scoops, then it will sound like 夢ならばどれほどよかったでしょう。They sound much flatter and boring, isn't it? You can follow the same guidance you see here to learn the rest of the phrasing in this section. Next, I'm gonna go over some difficult pronunciations in the same verse. As you can see on your right, this song has so many Japanese R's, which is one of the hardest sounds for English speakers to pronounce. If you have trouble pronouncing Japanese R, I have a video that explains it in detail, so please watch the video from the link right here. To sound natural singing Japanese R, you can make the sound more towards English L. For example, the first line of this song starts with 夢ならばどれほどよかったでしょう。If you sing those R's in more of English rolled tongue way, then it will sound like 夢ならばどれほどよかったでしょう。It sounds kind of unnatural, isn't it? This will be the same for the third line of this song. Instead of singing 忘れた with rolled tongue kind of sound, you can sing like 忘れたものを取りに帰るように。 Question of the day. What are your favorite J-pop or anime songs that you like to sing? Please let me know in the comment section below. Now let's jump into second half of the verse.There are a few double vowels in this section, which English speakers may have trouble deciding how to pronounce. When there are two or more vowels combined in Japanese, you may think these vowels are spoken or sung as one syllable, like a or we. But you still need to say these separately and pronounce like ae and ue. Especially the an syllable you can find in this section can be pretty confusing for English speakers since there are three vowels combined together. You can pronounce this as an, not an. Now I'm gonna sing and demonstrate how these multiple vowels would sound like in this section. Pay attention to how the syllables with multiple vowels are pronounced.
戻らない幸せがあること最後にあなたが教えてくれた言えずに隠してた暗い過去もあなたがいなきゃ永遠に暗いまま
Now let's move on to the pre-chorus sectionThere are a couple of difficult words and pronunciations packed into this short section. So the first off is the word KITTO. When two same consonants are combined in Japanese, there will be a quick pause in between the previous syllable and the later syllable. So for this word, instead of saying kito or kito, we say kitto, kitto. Notice there is a small pause in between ki and to, and it will sound like kitto. The next tricky word in this pre-chorus is mou. There is a rule in Japanese singing that when the exact order of o and u are combined, you can omit the u sound and pronounce them as a long o vowel. So in this case, it'll pronounce as mo instead of saying mo. Last but not least, the word kizutsuku can be the hardest word to pronounce for English speakers. The first syllable of this ki is really simple, but the second and the third syllable, which are zutsu, are pretty difficult to even for Japanese people to say sometimes. The trick for pronouncing zu is to say English zu, but cutting it short and say zu. For the tsu syllable, I've explained how to pronounce in detail in the previous video I made, but the tip for this is to combine the ending sound of hits and the vowel u together and say tsu. When you combine all of these syllables, it will sound as kizutsuku, kizutsuku. Now I'm gonna sing this phrase slowly so you can sing along with me to practice singing this phrase.
きっともうこれ以上傷つくことなどありはしないとわかっている。
Alright, finally, let's take a look at the chorus of this song. Pronunciation for this section is pretty straightforward, but there's some interesting vocal styling happening in this chorus. First off, to make the first line of this chorus sound like cool J-pop, you'll need to switch up the rhythm to sing like
あの日の悲しみさえ。
If you don't sing the first part of this phrase rhythmically, it will sound like
あの日の悲しみさえ。
This can sound more like traditional Japanese enka or minyo. This is true for all the other lines of this chorus.
そのすべてを愛してたあなたとともに。
You might have noticed here that the pitch goes pretty high. When singing this phrase, you want to use your head voice. Instead of singing like
あなたとともに
to bring up your chest voice up, like sing it more like
あなたとともに。
If you have trouble singing with head voice, please check out the video above where I go through some head voice exercises. Okay, I hope you enjoyed watching this video and learned how to sing Lemon. If you want to hear me demonstrating the entire first part of this song, or interested in simply hearing me the cover of this Lemon, please check out the cover video I have published recently from the link above or from the end screen. If you liked the video and want to see more videos like this, please don't forget to hit like and subscribe and write a comment below since they motivate me so much to create future contents. Alright then, until next time. それではまた次回の動画でお会いしましょう。さようなら。